Hello and welcome. We are coming to you live from the headquarters of Outlook in New Delhi. I am Ruben Banerjee, the editor-in-chief, and joining me are Sunil Menon, our managing editor, and Mr. Giridhar Jha, our senior editor. And we are here together to try and make sense of the exit poll findings, which had kept the entire country glued today for much of the day. And the findings, if with a caveat, exit polls necessarily are not the final results. They may go wrong, going by what happened in 2004. But if these exit polls hold true till then, to on Thursday, May 23rd, the NDA led by Mr. Prime Minister Narendra Modi seems to be headed to a landslide win, and they will be voted to power emphatically. Now, we already have a clutch of exit poll findings. Republic Sea Water, they are giving, projecting 287 seats to NDA as against 128 to the UPA. NewsX Neta is giving the NDA 242. Times Now VMR is giving 306 to the NDA, almost a landslide. News Nation is giving 282 to 292 to NDA. And Republic Janki Baat is giving more than 305. They are giving 305 seats to NDA. So, Sunil, almost a landslide for the BJP.
Yeah. I mean, very dramatic developments today. In fact, of course, that going back to that caveat, it is an essential caveat, and because finally this is only an approximation of what the actual results may be. What is surprising here is that all of the exit pollsters seem to have a kind of consensus. The range is between 50 seats. Within that, the kind of figures that people had expected earlier, those have not been borne out at all.
Because everyone, before these exit polls, almost everyone was saying that it will be a very close fight.
That's right.
And then nothing of that has happened.
This will have, if these numbers bear out, you know, because some of the exit polls are going by very, very big sampling sizes, 7.5 lakh and all that, I think, by Sea Water and or perhaps Axis. So the degree of accuracy, we may have to, like, you know, as of now, we have to be in a position of assuming that this is a kind of conditional truth and analyze that. Of course, within 4 days, we'll get the real results. But if these results hold, what we are looking at is a substantially different kind of government coming in than what one had assumed, not even vis-a-vis the kind of third front Congress coalition that we may have assumed, or a kind of BJP with reduced numbers having to be dependent on Jagan Mohan, Naveen Patnaik. You know, in every case, everyone was predicting a kind of federalizing of the government.
In the next hung parliament.
Yeah, hung parliament with the regional leaders, actually.
Giridhar, going by this, if these results are true, if these findings are true, what's your biggest takeaway?
Biggest takeaway is that we all talked about that we are going to have a hung parliament. And we all talked about that there was a Modi lahar, Modi wave in 2014. But if projected figures are coming true on Thursday, then this election may see the same kind of
And result. How is it that we in the media generally did not find this lahar?
Primarily because of two reasons. Because we all sought to see the confederation of opposition parties, the Mahagathbandhan, primarily in UP and Bihar. Together, these two states have 120 seats, and in 2014, they had won 104 seats in these two states. Other than that, the BJP had done badly in three states in assembly elections. The Congress had formed government in Rajasthan.
And they normally hold their voting patterns.
So we considered, I mean, those results to be kind of a yardstick, that pattern will follow in Lok Sabha election.
But possibly
if projected figures are.
So what could have possibly happened? Like, generally, you have, like, if you take this trend and
there's one more reason why, you know, this whole thing about journalists reading the mood, which is a kind of an abstract thing, and the more statistical kind of methods, that mismatch between them, how they can actually, both of them are fallible, no, neither of them are infallible, but why people may have misread potentially what's actually happening is because journalists certainly tend to focus more on the what's available in the public sphere. And public sphere, if you look at, you know, the degree of consensus there, the 2019 is not 2014. when Modi was coming for the first time, the kind of surge that he had, the enthusiasm that he had, that was seen to have ebbed away a little bit in the 5 years in of having between, seen the government,
yeah,
and
yeah,
and it was a kind of a holding operation more than actually a, you know.
No, but in the run up to the elections, we were talking about, at least many people, many observers were pointing out to farmers' distress.
That's right.
Demonetization. Then what changed?
Was it
Balakot?
See, in a Balakot, you know, it's you cannot actually underestimate the power of a nationalist kind of rhetoric, because you know, one thing is that, like, you know, underflowing underneath the mass media and even mass media's outreach to, like, you know, on the ground, there is certainly a thing about you know, the mobile telephony actually having spread way beyond now than it was used to. You know, the spread is way more than what it was in 2014, and cheap Wi-Fi, everyone is consuming, the output is massive, and, you know, the things about Balakot and were being heard in rural areas, being spoken in almost identical way. There is a kind of a homogenization across, potentially.
Going by this exit poll, I think I have a feeling that this persona of Modi subsumed almost everything.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's
it's
right.
Modi who has, right?
Yeah, it was Modi versus all. I mean, Modi has been the most decisive factor in this election.
And because you are from Bihar, I'll take you to Bihar. It's very phenomenal. Like, we talked about Mahagathbandhan, Nitish Kumar, RJD, Congress, even the others, bit players, Jitin Ram Majhi and all.
True.
Now, everyone was expecting that it will be a close fight there.
Yeah.
It's a landslide. India Today Axis is saying BJP will get 38 to 40, Congress only 2. So, yeah, it's a no contest.
Yeah, it's a no contest, and all of them have given more than 30 seats. But remember, Bihar, Nitish and BJP, they have been unbeatable combination since 2005. Ever since Lalu Yadav was ousted from power, they have never lost an election. And, you know, almost all elections, they have got more than 30 seats. Last time they got 31.
Fine, I agree. Like, last time they got 33.
Yeah.
Right.
Last time they got 31.
31.
When Nitish was not with them.
Nitish was not with them.
But now Kushwaha has gone out. He would won 3 seats.
That means it's difficult to compare Bihar 2014 to now.
But
you know,
if we go by the figures of 2014, Nitish had got 15% of votes, BJP had got 29% of votes, and Paswan had got 6% votes.
That's
altogether
safe.
They had gone about, yeah, they had got about 52% votes. So they had got, so they contested this election together. So they were anyway formidable combination.
The same aggregation of vote shares was what was done for UP in terms of SP and BSP.
Yeah.
Then it's, you know, the numbers, you know, only a couple of them are giving, it's like widely ranging actually UP. A couple of votes are giving.
Before we come to, like, if this Bihar trend stays,
yeah,
then the epitaph has been written for Lalu Yadav.
That's
right.
True.
Sure.
In parliamentary election, he has never won more than 4 seats. In past say 14 years, he has never gone beyond, even though he has been getting 20% of votes, mm-hmm, election after election, but that has not been translated into seats, number of seats. This time, there were talks about a neck and neck contest, because there was a combination. They had Mukesh Sahni, who is an EBC leader,
yeah,
then they had Jitin Ram Manjhi, who is a Mahadalit leader, they had Upendra Kushwaha, who is an OBC leader, with Congress and Lalu
Yadav.
Right.
Who's exited from
considered to be a very formidable.
So everyone before pre-election, everyone was talking about that the BJP, which had done so exceptionally well in 2014, possibly can't repeat its performance,
right,
and they were expecting that they will come down.
Yeah.
And they will come down substantially, particularly in these heartland states of,
that's
Bihar,
right,
and Uttar Pradesh.
Yeah.
Now, looking at UP, TV9 C voter is saying BJP is getting 32, SVBSP is getting only 40. So they haven't really lost. They have lost, like, if that be the case, from 71 they are coming down to 30.
Yeah.
But their fall, the decline hasn't been that substantial at least. It was being projected to be. They have cut their losses. Times Now VMR is giving BJP 58,
yes,
out of 80.
Yes.
And SP BSP on the contrary is getting only 20. And Janki Baat is giving 46 to 47 to BJP. And SP BSP is 40. So what went wrong? This talk of Mahagathbandhan, Mayawati and Akhilesh transferring votes.
But still in UP they have gone down.
They have gone down, but then marginally.
73 to 38 or 58.
Yeah,
made up for the loss in other states.
30 was actually the bottommost that people were giving, because, you know, no one expected BJP to get completely decimated in UP. You know, 30 from 71 was considered quite a reasonable fall for people.
Have managed to limit their losses.
Limit
their
losses.
In
that's
UP,
the thing.
And that is very, very significant.
Low voting share, low vote shares, right? Vote turnouts. turnout was, I think...
Turnout was okay. It was not such low. But UP, they were expected to fare very badly.
That's right.
That way even 40 seats, 50 seats is considered to be very good.
We talked about Congress winning these three assembly elections in November, December. Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan. Madhya Pradesh, what happened? What went wrong? The results seem to have just turned. Like now in Madhya Pradesh, TV9 C voter is giving BJP 24, Congress 5. Today's Chanakya is giving BJP 29, Congress is only 2. ABP is giving BJP 24 there, as against Congress is 5. So just 3 months before the Lok Sabha elections, or 4 months, Congress won that state. It was a close fight, but then Congress is in power. And then in Lok Sabha, the people are voting differently. Normally, it doesn't happen that way.
But these are states which normally hold their voting patterns.
Yeah, normally it doesn't happen that way.
Potentially, they made a mistake in the choice of chief ministers. I mean, that it is undeniable that, line of argument they normally dismiss out of hand. But the kind of momentum that they had built up before the elections, both these states had young chief ministers, potential chief minister faces, who were actually discarded. Rajasthan, they made a mess of with... Gehlot and Pilot, the whole thing kind of, coming unstuck there.
In fact, even in Rajasthan, the exit poll projections are not looking that good for Congress.
No, even in assembly elections, if you see the vote percentage, in Madhya Pradesh, BJP had got more than Congress.
That's right. It was a tough fight.
0.4% or something, 0.04%.
It was actually
in Rajasthan, it was kind of negligible.
Very totally this thing.
So, one takeaway is that definitely the assembly elections and national general elections are altogether two different things for voters. Here, voters have voted for a national leader kind of. And that is where Modi has played a key role.
There's also one thing here, the conflict is often at the level of the individual voter. He himself has conflicting loyalties. If you go down to, let's say, Western UP, where RLD was part of the Mahagathbandhan. So, but your stereotypical voter there is a Jat, rural Jat voter. And, the loyalties can actually be shifting between BJP. Both of them are making demands on his loyalty. A nationalism kind of narrative is also very much there. The other thing is a very rooted local old Charan Singh kind of loyalty to the party. And you really never know. I mean, how things pan out at the...
Just a reminder for the viewers, if you have any questions, you can write it and we'll try and answer. But Giridhar, I'm still trying to figure out. So much was spoken about farmers' distress, demonetization, unemployment, inflation. Nothing seemed to have worked.
Yeah, because I feel two reasons that the opposition, they failed to project any pan-national leader. There was so much talk about Rahul Gandhi and he campaigned extensively. Somehow people felt that he was not the unanimous candidate of the opposition.
That's right.
I mean, there was always talk whether Rahul Gandhi would be prime minister or whether Third Front would put up its own candidate. There was no unanimity. I think they lost the plot when they failed to stitch up.
Together at an early stage.
Uttar Pradesh.
What happened to Rahul Gandhi? Because he seemed to be aggressively campaigning, and then Rafal never made any dent. Or yeah, Chokidar Chor hai.
Yeah, if these
it fizzled
are, yeah.
If these numbers
that
are
did not,
overlooked,
that,
yes,
that did not.
Yes.
It was more of a kind of a negative campaign which did not work out.
So he had a crisis of credibility because very recently, because the latest issue of Outlook has a cover interview with the Congress President Rahul Gandhi, and he seemed to be very upbeat.
That's right.
And nothing seemed to have worked.
A few of the exit poll results apparently, in the earlier phases, their internal polls, all of them seem to indicate the kind of result that everyone had expected earlier. This is kind of reduction for BJP, a kind of healthier turnout for the rest of them, but which is why all the regional leaders were supposed to be now coming to Delhi. Even we had that kind of symbolism on the cover. And Jagan Reddy, Naveen Patnaik, Mamata Banerjee, all the talk, all the focus was on these
and very interestingly,
leaders.
Significantly, whatever, apart from the Hindi heartland, the BJP seems to have done exceptionally, going by these exit polls. And again, a caveat, exit polls are not the final word, it's final result.
Yeah.
They can at best be projections. And BJP has done very well in West Bengal and Odisha.
That's right.
Now, West Bengal, which was said to be the bastion of Mamata Banerjee, and BJP never had really, they had one MP in the last time. I think it was Babul Supriyo, and then they had two from actually Darjeeling.
From Darjeeling and Asansol.
So they never really had a toehold. They never really had a presence there. And West Bengal NDTV is projecting BJP. VMR is saying 11 to BJP. C voter is giving 11 to BJP. Janki Bath is actually giving 22 of the 42 seats.
And that's
so
phenomenal.
It's actually the kind of politics, you know, there is ICS degree of similarity between what Mamata did in Bengal politically and Pinarayi did in Kerala, which is actually take your politics to such a highly pitched polarized level that it opens up the space for the those who are against your very hardline point of view to cohere towards the other extreme. So which sort of ensures that the middle parties actually collapse. And
so what BJP has essentially done, going by these exit polls, they have cut their losses, they have succeeded in limiting their losses in Uttar Pradesh. They have done remarkably well in Bihar, going by these results.
Karnataka.
And they have made heavy inroads in West Bengal and in Orissa.
Orissa,
the exit polls are saying that out of 21 seats, BJP will get 10 to 12.
Yeah.
And they had only one the last time.
Karnataka that way is not very surprising because, you know, it's kind of roughly divided. The southern Karnataka thing was Congress and JDS were actually, the allies were actually at loggerheads with each other over candidates. And the northern half of the state is actually bipolar between, straight fight between Congress and BJP, and it's a Lingayat stronghold. And the coastal belt is very, very heavily Hindutvized. So those results are not surprising per se.
One of our viewer is writing that exit polls, most journalists seem to be taking the exit polls at face value. Of course not. We have been constantly saying exit polls are not the final results.
And they have often gone wrong.
And they have gone wrong definitely in 2004. So one doesn't know. But going by what the projections are, which may not be written on stone, it seems that NDA led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi is coming back to power. If this Maharashtra, again BJP is doing exceptionally well. BJP plus Shiv Sena is 38 according to Times Now.
All those grand speeches by Raj Thackeray, you know, sort of
all fizzled out.
Yes.
So overall, going by like, of course, as the day as the night progresses, we'll be talking more about these exit polls. But what is the sense you are getting that it's Narendra Modi who matters alone in this country?
Certainly. There may be very, very heavy disagreements, but the sheer polarizing effect of certain kinds of narratives, people on the other side don't realize how effective it is on the other side, how homogenizing it is on the other side. Nationalism is a kind of logic that, you know, all over the country it might work, with the exception of perhaps Kashmir, you know, and no one else actually has an argument against it in a positive way. But to actually point out that, you know, nuances to the argument is not something that you can take to the voters.
Also, it underlines their organizational work.
They realize
that they had already got.
This is remarkable because I have a particular interest in Odisha because I happen to spend quite a bit of time in that state. And India Today Axis, it's what they are predicting is phenomenal. BJP 15 to 19 out of the 21 seats.
That's clean.
BJD is 2 to 6. 2 possibly. If it's 15, then BJD gets 6. If BJP gets 19, BJD is 6, 2. So end of the road for at least.
Of course, we haven't. These are not the assembly.
The assembly.
So there may be a disjunction between how they voted. That will be very interesting.
I am being told that people in Odisha have voted differently for Lok Sabha, and because that is Navin Patnaik's bastion. Navin Patnaik isn't that very unpopular. But there was an undercurrent, and I was being told that people in Odisha wanted to see Navin Modi as the Prime Minister, and they were voting differently. But this is still phenomenal. BJP 15 to 19. It's nothing short of a revolution.
There is something to be said about, there was a lot of talk about the BJP, the 2014 Modi wave actually reaching certain zones of the country belatedly 5 years later, like the Northeast, Bengal, Orissa. So they're experiencing the first thrill of joining the mainstream in a sense. and that seems to have worked. I mean, if also
it's a big letdown for regional leaders, because
very big letdown.
Many of them, like Naveen or Jagan Mohan Reddy, they had deliberately not entered into any pre-poll alliance.
That's right.
Because they thought that there would be a scenario these people can call the shots in the event of a third front
all
government.
All the big political that leaders were actually
that hasn't happened.
They were all betting on this.
Even if Naveen does well in the next assembly elections. Setback in parliamentary polls will be a big setback.
Our viewer is writing, what about nota? It's too early, we wouldn't know. You'll have to wait till
May 23rd.
So we wouldn't know. But Giridhar, like, before signing off, and we'll be back again on Facebook, doing another Facebook Live at 9, trying to make sense of these exit poll predictions. What next for Congress?
Congress will have to, I mean, kindly. Completely revamped, but whether question arises whether there would be any leader other than Rahul Gandhi or Priyanka Gandhi beyond the family. The problem with Congress at national level that it has failed to prop up any strong regional level. Take Bihar for instance.
Exactly.
At one point of time when they lost power to Lalu Yadav in 1990, Congress was the main opposition party, and BJP and Samta party, they were nowhere. But a point came when Congress joined Lalu government. And it became part of the Lalu government. So that ground, it ceded to BJP, and BJP sometimes emerged as the main opposition party. Now there is no leader in the Congress. So that is their problem.
My colleague Suraj Vadwa is writing that it's Modi wave which is at work. Possibly going by these exit polls. Just a quick recap. Republic C voter is projecting 287 to NDA. NewsX Neta is projecting 242. Times Now VMR 306. News Nation 282 to 292. Republic Janki Baat is giving NDA around 305 seats. So great day for NDA if the results hold true.
No, so these numbers are broadly the same in one sense. The numbers are the same as 2014, but it will be a qualitatively different government in my view. I mean, you know, Amit Shah is going to be an MP. He will join the government. The whole thing and getting an endorsement from the people after 5 years will give them a kind of momentum that. Different kind of so how things pan out will be very, very interesting to watch.
So interesting times ahead. So we'll see you again after about half an hour, and keep watching, keep checking out www.outlookindia.com, where our reporters across the country are filing in with their analysis, what exactly is happening, why these exit poll trends. So we'll keep you updating, and we'll take you, our reporters will help you to make sense of these exit poll trends, and we'll keep trying to take you beyond the headlines. Thank you. See you in again.